I loud and clear?
Yes.
Okay, so for the first time I am presenting in front of technical analysts. Until now it's always been either traders, investors, or maybe collegians, MBAites, etc. So this would be the first time I would be presenting in front of people, those who are part of Atma or maybe Atma of technical analysis. So those who believe in technical analysis and practice it as a religion. So let me get into what I will be presenting today. Now, although the PowerPoint is mentioned as Sensex versus Dow Jones, now this is a long-term study because the biggest data which we have on technicals is for Dow Jones Index. We don't have many others. Even in case of Sensex, ideally we should have it from 1981, but we have some backdated data since 1978. So what we'll be doing is we'll be looking towards two economies maybe, or two countries, and how are they placed at. So this is basically a longer term study on how US markets grew up in the 1980s, wherein they moved up something like 11 times in 15-17 years, and maybe India is placed similarly over the next few years. So what we'll be doing first is what I call it as a 13-year cycle model, or maybe a model on which longer term bull markets are made. So out here, what is the model? This we have been presenting for the last few years. The first one was done in September 2005 by my senior partner Mr. Fidai for a broking firm. He's with us today. So any queries during that time, you can always ask him. And post that, I've been presenting this 13-year cycle model every time when we see an opportunity into the markets. So around 2009 in August, when we were at 12,000-14,000, we did a seminar all over India in almost 6 to 8 cities, and again in August 2011 in some forums. So this is the new presentation which I have made. What do we see and how do we believe it would happen? So the first thing is, before I start the model, I am talking about very simple things. Although for you all it is very simple, but when I go to normal investors, even this seems to be difficult. So I'll just rush through it. Everyone must be knowing about the flag and pole, the basics. So what we see is, if the pole size is 100 and the flag is say something like 20, you know the target prices are 20 points on the flag breakout and another 50 points on the pole size. Now this is a simple model. Now what I look into is called as the 13-year cycle. Now 13-year cycle is for Sensex, it could be different years for different indices. So what we see is, this is something like a 30-year cycle, 50-year cycle on longer term charts. So the first part of the cycle is, wherein markets grow by, see a super bull run. A super bull run implies 10 times return in 10 years. So if you put a CAGR, it is much more huge. Not even 15% compounding, we are looking at 30%, 50% every year. So that is the first phase. Once that bull run is over, we see a very long period of consolidation for something like twice the amount of time of the bull run or equivalent to the same time. Now this is where the classical fundamental analysis part, invest for long term, you'll always make money, goes wrong. The general assumption is, if you buy today, for the next 10 years, you will always be profitable or you will beat FD returns. This is the period where it goes wrong dramatically. So for example, how many of you all are from equities since the 1990s? Can somebody tell me what was the top in 1990s for the Sensex?
It was something around 4,500 in 1990.
4,500? Around 1992. And what was the bottom in 2003? 2000, something like 1980. Now that is how many years? 13 years. And a return of minus 50%. Inflation adjusted, you have lost all your money. The way we say it, or maybe FD adjusted, you have lost all your money. So this is what I call as a period wherein equities give you terrible returns. Although people may not see it that way. Suppose that we have another bull run, which is equivalent to the super bull run run which happened many years back. Maybe economies take that much time to shape up. Maybe many cycles, economical cycles. So what we see is, once this is taken off, we'll get into a super bull run, which will be again for the same amount of years. So for example, we had X years, maybe 13, 17, 25. We'll see another 13 years of a bull run. And this would be again a best part. Now what we see is, in this case, we had a super bull run for US in the 1940s to the 1960s. Just before it, people talk about the economic depression. Maybe a lot of economic depression analysis came in the 2008. When you read online, we'll get into a depression. Markets are going to collapse. It will freeze. Then we had something like a consolidation for a long time. So these are case studies wherein I'm taking Dow Jones as my base and what we see on Sensex. So this is the last time we are in. So last time you were at August 2009. This was August 2011, and maybe we are somewhere here in between this phase before the next blowout starts. So now I'll start with my comparisons, talking about Dow Jones versus Sensex. So we'll see some longer term charts, starting from the rally of 1940s to 1960s for Dow Jones and the Sensex rally of 1980s to 1990s. Now, one of the major reasons when I have a problem with a lot of investors is, when I say I buy Nifty at 5200 for a target of 5800, I get this old investor, he says you should be long term. You cannot be short term. The real money is made in the long term. Now, anyone out here who's profited big way from the 1980s, or maybe their parents have benefited a lot from the 1980s. HUL shares, IPO shares of Reliance. If you not any of your parents holding Reliance, no one. HUL, Colgate. Anyone else who's inherited a lot of shares? So I had this old guy telling me I bought HUL at 100 rupees. For example, Cipla is worth, Cipla 10,000 investment may be worth 3 crores, 5 crores in the last 20-30 years. So in 1980s, we had an index of base of 100-120. So let us see what happened in the 1940s and 1980s for Dow Jones. Now this is the economic depression times of 1932. Now this is one of the reasons a lot of people talk about 90% erosion, or whenever a company which has been something like a DLF or a Unitech, the stories may come down 90% of value. The base of all this analysis is in 1932, in the depression, the index of Dow Jones came to 10% of the value. So from 400 to it was 42. So this is where a lot of base is made for the 89%, 11% theory. So this is how we say RCOM 770, it should come to 70, all the cycle stocks. Now this is the longer term channel for Dow Jones in the 1940s to 1980s. If you notice, this is one more reason why we should believe in technical analysis. Because we may not have had data in the 1940s. We didn't have computers at that point of time. But if you look at the movement of the prices, it trends to the technicals we look at. So generally, whenever I go to a seminar where we have a lot of investors, they believe technical analysis is something new. So when you look at the longer term charts from the 1940s, my belief in technicals increases big way. So now if you look at this chart, the standard which we do is trend lines, keep joining the bottoms. Can you all clearly see the channels? So this was the super bull run period. which continued. We'll look into those calculations, but we'll see how the rally was. A channeled move, something like what we saw in our model, continuous cycle model. Then a huge consolidation for almost decades to come, something like 17 years. Seems very similar to what we saw in the model. Now, one more thing to note out here is, this is US markets and what happens post the breakout. And how resistances on the trend lines continue to be followed. So what, something if it worked in 1940s, the same thing is working right now. Now let us look into the next chart, which is Sensex again. Can you all see a channel move similar? Similar to the 1940s. We'll see similar 4 to 5 bottoms on the lower trend line. And something similar on the upside. And then a long consolidation. What I called as the period of 1992 to 2003. Returns of minus 50%. Then the breakout happened somewhere in 2005. Which is very clear. It got retested in 2008. So what does simple technicals tell you? After the retest, there should be a bigger move towards the flag, right? Although we see it mostly on the shorter term patterns. We never look into 15-year or 50-year chart or 100-year chart. So now this is the retest. Now I'll do a calculation for the same. Now this is our chart. Now let us look into the calculations. Dow was 92 price in 1942. By 1966, it was around 1000. Now that would be something like 10 times or maybe more, 11 times, right? In how many years? 24 years. 17 years of consolidation. So for 17 years, it was in a range of 525, 550 into 1100.